वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ द चैप्टर रूरल लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट इन सिविक्स. आई हैड ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज द लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट एंड द पंचायती राज सिस्टम विच वॉज वेरी वेरी प्रोमिनेंट इन द एंशियंट टाइम्स एंड ड्यूरिंग द ब्रिटिश रूल. इट हैज़ लॉस्ट इट्स सिग्निफिकेंस और वॉज लेस इफेक्टिव. And how after independence the Panchayati Raj system again was revived so that the local affairs of the people could be solved there and there without any delay. And how each Panchayat has panch, means five people, elder people of the village, who used to look into the affairs of the villages and solve the problems, and they had to abide by the whatever the decision was of the Panchayats, panch. And I have also told you that the Panchayati Raj system is a three-tier system, where you have the Panchayat at the village level, block samitis at the block level, and Zila Parishads at the district level. Now I have told you that the Panchayat, they have three parts: the Gram Sabha, Gram Panchayat, and the Nyay Panchayat. So let us read, know about what a Gram Sabha is. So the Gram Sabha is defined in the Constitution of India under Article 243B. So what is the definition? There are lakhs of villages in our country. So many villages are there. Some of them are big, whereas some of them are very, very small. A village which has a population of 500 or more people has a Gram Sabha. You have to remember this very, very important point, that Gram Sabha has a population of 500 or more people. It is a permanent body. A Gram Sabha is essentially a village assembly. Gram Sabha, Gram means village, Sabha is assembly, okay? So it is a village assembly. All the adults of the village or the people who are 18 years or above are members of the Gram Sabha. So everybody who is of 18 years of age or above is the member of this Gram Sabha. The Gram Sabha holds meeting at least twice a year. Two times in a year they hold a meeting. And what do? They discuss the important matters and problems regarding the village. Okay, any problem, any issue they want to talk it out or sort out related to the village, they discuss it. It also elects the members of the Gram Panchayat, like the voting system we have, no? So Gram Panchayat, I've told you, five people are there, so they are the ones who elect the people of the members of the Gram Panchayat. Thus, the members of the Gram Sabha ensure their development through their participation and mutual cooperation in the decision-making process. So together, they unanimously they think about it, that who should be the right person and why do they, and they elect the person members of the Gram Panchayat, so that whatever decisions are taken in the future by them, they are for the benefit of the village, Gram Sabha, of the people, and so that the development of the village can take place. And whatever, this is a very important fact. So for any decision making process, for any cooperation, their participation is very, very important. So they do it by making a correct election. They do it by electing the correct person for the development of the Gram or the village. All decisions of the Panchayat are taken through Gram Sabha, and no decision is official and valid without the consent of the Gram Sabha. So suppose these members, the panch, they take a decision, and whatever decision they take, they tell it to the people, the Gram Sabha, and if they say that they have to go ahead with it, they think that it is for the betterment of the village, for good of the village, and the correct decision is being taken, they will give a thumbs up, they will find it valid, and then, or agree to consent is agree to the decision, and then accordingly the decision would be final. Now comes the Gram Panchayat. So the Gram Panchayat consists of members elected by the Gram Sabha. Like I told you, these people, the people, they elect the Gram Panchayat. And it is headed by a Sarpanch. So there are five people. So the head is called the Sarpanch. Head of all the, among the five, the head is called the Sarpanch. Notably, some seats are reserved in the Gram Panchayat for people belonging to the scheduled caste or the scheduled tribe. So in villages, you have people belonging to different caste and creed. So the minority class, like you can call it the scheduled caste or the scheduled tribes, they also, because the upper caste system is very, very prominent in villages, right? So the Sabha or the Sarpanch, if he belongs to a different caste, he may take decisions against these people belonging to these castes. So there is also a representative of this caste, so that to avoid any kind of partiality, so that the decision is in good for all as a community. 1/3 of the seats are reserved for the women, because a woman is 1/3 of the seats are also reserved for the women. So again, to improve on the decision making, or improve on the, you can say, the affairs, internal affairs of the village. Gram Panchayats are the basic units of local administration for village level. So at the village level, everything, whatever government rules or government policies or government betterment, anything that comes through the administration, government, first it comes to the Gram Panchayat and then subsequently to the people. So it plays a very, very important role. Then let us talk about the Nyay Panchayat, the third part of the Panchayati system. The Nyay Panchayat is the village, as you can see, the Nyay means, you can say, anything related to dispute, justice. So what happens, justice is done in the court. So it is also the village court. Only some big villages have a Nyay Panchayat. The members of the Nyay Panchayat are usually elected by the Gram Panchayat. So Nyay Panchayat, big villages only have a Nyay Panchayat. And who elects the members of the Nyay Panchayat? The people of the Gram Panchayat. Their job is to settle disputes among the people at village level. In doing so, they provide cheap and speedy justice to the people. So any dispute that is taking place and which can be solved at the village level, they solve it. And what happens? This is cheap. They don't have to go to the district court, or and it will waste a lot of money and time. Justice would be delayed. But with this Gram Nyay Panchayat, this justice is speedy and cheap for the people. So what are the features of the Gram? Okay, let us stop here today. We will do the third video and we will talk about the features of the Gram Panchayat and the functions of the Gram Panchayat. Please go through the chapter carefully. Thank you.